generally when I get a call, people let me know what their problem is. And generally speaking, I hear that they're either depressed or anxious. I mean, that's what's underlying whatever else they might be saying to me. So when those folks come on in, what we need to do and what we do is we sit together, of course, first and foremost, and then just begin a conversation about what's bringing them here today. And through that conversation, we begin to explore. And here's what we're going to really be exploring, because depression and anxiety are about emotional regulation. And the regulation occurs in three different dimensions. And so we have to explore the three different dimensions. One of the dimensions is the environment. And the first environment in which we grow is the family of origin. So we want to begin to understand that particular ground, really, from which everything else is going to be stemming. So we want to understand that environment, the family of origin environment. That's very important. Then we want to look at, and just through conversation, we want to look at and understand and explore the interpersonal relationships, because it's through these interpersonal relationships in the family of origin and throughout life, wherein we begin to understand ourselves and our environment through this interchange. And many things get interjected. That means mom and dad says, this is what must be done, and that's what happens. So we begin to develop patterns of thought during that period of time, which may suit a 2 or 3, 4, 7-year-old, but not a 25-year-old or an 18-year-old or a 60-year-old. So we want to begin to explore those, because they are seeded and they become, we think of those ideas, we might not even recognize their ideas. Actually, we might not recognize we're talking to ourselves, and we are. And we don't often, even when we recognize we're talking to ourselves, don't recognize that they're actually thoughts that are introjected. They're not part of ourselves. They're actually somebody else's idea that we haven't explored and examined. So this is vitally important. And the third sphere is our own intrapsychic self. So what's going on internally? What signals are we getting from our body? You know, using proprioception, if you will, and just looking at our own selves from the inside out. What's going on here? How do we begin to uncover our actual true selves? And that's a place where meditation is very helpful and useful, and really growing awareness. And there are many methods to grow awareness, and we do that here in the work that we do, both by sitting and through conversation and by developing a deeper and deeper presence as we work together. You know, mindfulness has appeared on the therapeutic scene in the last 10 years or so. The reality is that mindfulness or presence in psychotherapy has been around for quite a long time. And really it's the cornerstone and substrate of any and all of the work that I do, insofar as my work and my job is to be present to you, to really be in the room with you, be present to you. And our work together becomes a one-point meditation, actually, insofar as I'm here present and you're sitting opposite me, and my full attention is on you, one-pointed attention on you, really listening to what you have to say, really using all of my senses so that not only do I hear what you say, but that my entire perceptual apparatus is open to you so that I can clearly understand and get a deep understanding of the meaning of what your life is and what you're trying to share with me.